Welcome back. You're watching The Globe on the SABC News Channel. Now, former Foreign Minister Mokhtar Khan has been named as Mali's interim Prime Minister, and this move is likely to trigger the lifting of sanctions imposed by the West African regional bloc ECOWAS in the aftermath of a military coup last month.
A Malian diplomat has been named as the country's interim prime minister in a move set to prompt the lifting of sanctions imposed following a military coup last month. Mokhtar Ouane was previously Mali's ambassador to the United Nations and the country's foreign minister. The appointment of civilians to the top jobs of Mali's transition had been a demand of the Economic Community of West African Nations, which cut off financial flows and closed borders after the August 18th ouster of President Ibrahim Boubacar Keita. But the West African leaders later softened their stance, and retired Colonel Barton Dow and junta leader Colonel Assimi Goïta were sworn in as President and Vice President on Friday. On the same day, ECOWAS said it would lift sanctions, which have caused a 30% slump in imports once a civilian premier was named. The men are now tasked with overseeing an 18-month transition back to civilian rule.
For more on this, we're now joined from West Africa by Kassoum Coulibaly, who's a Mali commentator, and he joins us from the capital, Bamako, to share the latest. Kassoum, always a pleasure to talk to you. Thanks for joining us. How has this name been received as the new prime minister has been put forward?
Thank you very much. I think that globally, inside the population, there is a good and a warm welcome to the new Prime Minister Mokhtar Ouane, who is a very experienced diplomat and a political leader in Mali since the former President Moussa Traoré was ruling the country until now. And we think that globally in the population, we all think that is a good choice for the country.
All right, so how powerful is the role of prime minister? Because you have an executive president. Most countries will have a ceremonial president with an executive prime minister. What's the situation in Mali? Does this person enjoy a lot of power?
Yes, when we look at the constitution of Mali, the prime minister is the chief of the government. And because he is ruling and leading the political, the government policy, you know, of the country, he is chosen among the political party who has the most number of MPs inside the National Assembly, and he has a good power, a big power on leading the country's activities, because we are in a semi-presidential law in Mali. The president is executive, but also the prime minister has big power in leading the country's activities. So in this situation of a transition, there is something new coming from the vice president, the Colonel Assimi Goïta, coming in place. But we need to see what can be his real power inside the three people who are going to lead the country.
Who chooses the cabinet? Is that the job of the prime minister?
Who? Sorry?
Who chooses the cabinet, the ministers that will work under him?
Yes, normally in the constitutional model, the prime minister presents the minister that can be chosen by the president, because the president is the one who takes the decree that nominates the cabinet members. So it is a discussion between the president and the prime minister. But in that transition situation, there can be a discussion between the president, the vice president, and the prime minister to choose the 20 or 25 people who can be leading the cabinet of the prime minister.
All right. Do you think this will be enough now for ECOWAS to lift the restrictions and the sanctions that they've put in place post the coup?
Yes. The ECOWAS leaders have said that when we have selected a civilian president of a transition and also a civilian vice prime minister, they can lift the sanctions against Mali. But during the last swarming ceremony, they said that there are some additional points they need to have clarification. What are the real power of the vice president? Because the Malian people are said that in case there is a problem with the vice president can take the power and to replace him immediately. But for the ECOWAS, they don't want this position to lead, let the military to come in power, maybe when the president will die or have some problem. So they see some discussion, the clarification they want to have before lifting the sanction against Mali. But we hope that they can reach an agreement tomorrow because we will have a new cabinet in place and the discussion can be put in place to lift the sanction. I am very optimistic on this way.
So what's happening now to the M5 RFP opposition grouping that for so long led the protests and some would say contributed significantly to the ousting of former President Abubakar Keita? What's happened to them? Because they don't seem to be being recognized in this new transitional government, or might we see them take up some ministerial positions?
Yes, I think that this is a very big issue in the country now, because maybe people thought that the M5 can have the president of the transition, maybe the prime minister, and that time they lose those two important positions. But in my understanding, this is maybe something we need to have a bad look on that. But I am sure that the new cabinet that can be in place tomorrow or the day after tomorrow, some of the M5 members can join. But don't forget that we will have another institution during the transition that can be the National Committee of Council of Transition. That is a kind of a national assembly for this interim period. I find that most of the members of the M5 can join this national council, and maybe the military and the president of a transition can have to say that they need to leave this position to the M5 leaders to lead this national council of the transition. That can be something we need to have a kind of balance in having the M5 in the National Assembly to contribute to design the new laws that can rebuild the country and to continue to make the monitoring and evaluation of public policies and public finance. I find that this is something very important. We need to wait for a moment to see what can be the next step on that position. But for me, I'm also optimistic of their role during this transition.
Have the M5 RFP said anything at all about the appointments that have been made to date?
Yes, they said that they are frustrated because the junta called them to bring and to nominate some people for the position of prime minister. Let me tell you that 14 people from the M5 has proposed their position, their willing to become the prime minister, and none of them has been selected. And now they are very frustrated because they consider that they have not been given the position they might have because of the contribution for the failing of the power of the former president, Ibrahim Boubacar Keita. But I can say that this is something we need to have an inclusive transition period. And I hope that the president of the transition, the vice president and the prime minister can have in a common understanding with the population to leave a kind of power to M5 people so that we can have a peaceful transition period and to let things happen very well for the happiness of the people of Mali.
All right. So what are the most urgent things that the Prime Minister has to deal with now that he's in office sort of starting to lead government through this interim phase? What's the most urgent thing on his desk?
I think that after having the new cabinet in place, we have a lot of financial difficulties now because the borders has been closed for more than 40 days, and we have some financial difficulties to solve now. I think that the economy and the financial situation in Mali is so bad now, we need to have a quick recovery. After, we need to see how we can engage with the new transition governance issues, like how to have a new constitution in place, how to put in place the actions to implement the peace agreement with the rebels, how we can continue to have the defense and security issues on board so we can recover all the superficie of the country, and also how we can prepare the next presidential and legislative election that can come in 2022. There is a lot of emergency and priorities to deal with, but we think that we need to bring all of the stakeholders on board and to have an inclusive transition period that we can join our strengths together and to make the country recovery as quick as possible.
Okay, and that's where we'll leave it. Kassoum, merci beaucoup. Reparle bientôt.
Merci, à bientôt.
Okay, thanks.